is the 10th session. So more than my topics, whatever I'm going to concentrate, I'm very sure that you'll be very much strong enough in what is machine learning and deep learning. I think this is not needed for me. So the topic which is given to me, the topic which is given to me is signal processing, that is biomedical signal analysis. I am very sure that for the past 9 sessions, definitely the speakers would not have concentrated on such area. And as specified by the student, so I have done my PhD in signal, biomedical signal. So with this introduction, let me start my topic. So my topics or my sessions, whatever I have frame or in such a way that 80% it is pure signals, 20% it is machine learning and deep learning. So to my knowledge, I think more about machine learning and deep learning architectures people would have given enough ideas. So I just want to concentrate more on signals, what are the different signals available, how to take these signals, how to play with the signals. Finally, we can see a demo with respect to two toolboxes present in MATLAB, and let me tell you how to classify any sort of disease if it is in the form of the signals. So this is the way I have phrased my title. So these are my contents. So introduction to bisignals, temporal and spectral representation, sensitive representation, visualization, MRA, that is multi-resolution analysis, and finally deep learning architecture. So when you go through my content, you can very well understand that the session is related to the title of FDP in the last portion. So with that, I will be concentrating more on signals. So coming to signal, we very well know what is a signal. For the first 5 minutes, I will just give a brief intro about what is a signal. Whatever we are conversing is basically a signal. So whatever, any form of quantity which is varying with respect to time is called as a signal. Now this signal can be a time domain, can be frequency domain. The signal can be of any form. It can be text, it can be picture, it can be video, it can be music. Everything is going to be called as a signal. So now what is a signal we are going to focus on is physiological signal. This physiological signal is also called as biomedical signals. Now we very well know that air is exploring very well in medical, that is healthcare. So we can say that recently one of the clinic which is present in Singapore, that hospital, their clinic is called as Mayo Clinic, and they are making use of this AI models, any sort of AI models for finding the problem in the eye. So in India it has not been explored still. We can say that in Bangalore, in some hospital, people are using AI models, are using machine learning and deep learning architectures, but still, in comparing to abroad, India is still in the initial stage. So, any sort of signal, when it is taken from the biological process of the human body, then it is going to be called as a biological signal. That's it. It's very simple. Any signal which is captured from the biological human body, then it is called as a biomedical signal. So, this biomedical signal, what is the necessity of this biomedical signal is, with the help of this signal, after capturing the signal, we are going to of analysis, and finally we are going to build the AI model. That's it. So whatever may be the different types of architectures like machine learning, different types of classifiers or deep learning, the final aim is we cannot give the input as it is. We cannot give the input as it is. So very simply, say for example, I can take a good example such that if it's tomorrow, probably 12 sessions will get over. And probably 12 speakers have shared their knowledge. So when this 3 hours, when this 3 hours images are being fed to any of the developed AI model, finally the model, whatever the model we are developing, finally that model should tell that this person is Jayalakshmy and she shared her knowledge on 10th session. If we are developing such a model, then we can say that we are expert in AI. So directly you cannot share this entire again. And finally, how it is being fed to any of the AI model that we are actually. So any sort of disorders or pathological process present in the human body can be diagnosed with the help of this machine learning or deep learning. Now, definitely, faculty or hope many are CSE students. Definitely, the faculty, since we have gone through a subject, whether it be CSE or ECE, we would have come across a term or subject which is called as biomedical instrumentation. And in that biomedical instrumentation, the basic thing for going through all the stages is nothing but a potential. So potential is basically voltage. That potential is called as an action potential. So we know that our human brain is having lots of neurons, and these neurons will communicate with each other. How it is going to get communicated is it is going to form in the form of ions. So in our body, there are small components such as sodium, potassium. All these are having some different types of ions, like positive and negative. When these ions are getting communicated to other neuron or in the form of a sensory input, it is going to have some potential, and that particular potential is called as a membrane potential. When this membrane potential is reaching a level, say for example, if I am fixing a voltage V 1 volt, and if that is considered as a threshold, and if this signal is crossing that limit, then that type of potential is called as action potential. And this action potential is the one which is very, very important for capturing any sort of signal from the human. Say for example, we very well know that even with a small fever, if you go to the doctor, any doctor, whoever may be the expert, the first process he will do is he will analyze our breathing sounds with the help of a stethoscope. So this stethoscope, we are not going to read about the stethoscope. This stethoscope is having n number of different small modules. We don't want that. With the help of this stethoscope, our breathing sounds will be detected. And this is one of the signals which is called as audio signal. This audio signal can be visualized in the spectrum analyzer or COXCO, and there we will get one signal which is called as a one-dimensional signal. Now whatever the signal I am going to talk in the next 100 to 120 slides, everything is going to be a one-dimensional signal. These one-dimensional signal means it is going to have only one dimension, which is nothing but it is going to vary in time. The time can be seconds, milliseconds, etc. So similarly, very simply, one of the sound which the doctors capture is respiratory, which is also called as breathing sound. One more sound, without knowing, so whenever we go to interview or something like that, automatically the heartbeat gets faster. And if I want to capture any sort of signal from the heart, then it is called as a ECG. Similarly, EEG, that is brain activity, can be measured with the help of the EEG. Similarly, if we run, our muscles will vibrate. This muscle vibration can be captured with the help of the sensor, and